So here I am in front of the Khumbu Icefall, arguably the most dangerous section of the mountain in terms of objective danger. So you kind of, well, there's no point in pointing at my screen, is there? You can see it behind me, it's pretty fun. Greetings from base camp, guys. So the mountain over my right ear is Changsi. That's in Tibet. That little pass in front is called Cholar. This whipped cream, ice creamy looking stuff right here is ice. That's the Khumbu Glacier, and we'll form the obviously the ice fall further up. That is the west shoulder of Everest. You can see the summit just pointing through, and then this mountain here is called Nuptse, which is pretty damn impressive. So namaste from Everest Base Camp. Today marks the fourth year anniversary since the massive Gorkha earthquake that shook Nepal back in 2015, caused immense devastation and killed close to 9,000 people. I was fortunate enough to miss that earthquake by merely hours, but this year I've returned to Nepal. I'm going to attempt to summit Mount Everest, and in so doing I'm hoping to raise $35,000 to build a library in a school called Sri Barmara Basic Secondary School in the Nuwakot district of Nepal, which was one of the most severely hit districts back in 2015. I'm pleased to say that to date we've raised almost 50% of that $35,000 through your kind donations. So we're currently sitting at just under 17,000. This expedition is entirely self-funded. Delighted to say that many friends, colleagues, clients and people within my professional and personal network have made generous contributions. And I guess I'd like to ask you to consider making a donation to the cause. The link is below. As I said, this expedition is entirely self-funded, therefore 100% of your donations go direct to Room to Read, the charity founded by John Wood, a former Microsoft executive. So as I say, please feel free to follow the link below. All major credit cards are accepted. All donations go direct to the charity itself and will go towards building that library in the school. Thank you so much, and stay tuned for additional updates. If you're keen to follow the expedition, there'll be occasional posts on my Facebook page, which is at Dan on Everest. Thank you so much. Bye for now. So this is camp one, sorry, camp two on Pomori, about 6,200 meters or something. On top of that big dome there is camp three. Almost got there the day before, but really feeling the altitude actually, so decided to come down and just rest for a couple of nights. Just a quick panorama here. That's Lingtran. This mountain is Changsi, I believe. This is what we're here for, the big one, Everest. Then there's Lhotse at the end of the Coombe there. And this is Nopse. Not a bad campsite, hey? Can't see it, but Amit Ablam's just around the corner. What a wonderful place.
Thank you.
Everest. A lot to see face. We're going tomorrow. Nupsi. Western Coombe. Armonia Interior in the background. And the team.
Bottle and camera and batteries and fucking radio. Pretty phenomenal day getting here, much longer than expected. There was a lot of traffic on the route and I dare say most of them pretty damn slow. Needless to say, got here, which is all good, so very much looking forward to getting a little bit of rest, and then we're getting up at 1 a.m. to attack the summit, which is what we're here for. So this is pre-cheese and biscuits, then I'm going to smash some ramen. Then I'm going to go for tea, and I'm going to try and go to sleep, because I've got to get up at 12 o'clock midnight. Anyway, I hope to be replaying this as part of a success story. Alrighty, bye for now. So camp 4, got a tent, sucking some ooze at the moment, 7,900 meters, and just about to have some cheese and biscuits, of all things. Wet lamps. Thank you for the Kendall mint cake. to the top of the world. Thanks, girls. See you soon. Hey, Mika, Alex, it's Uncle Dan. We're on the top of Mount Everest in
Jesse did the base camp.
May the 23rd. It's sea boys.
So most teams have summited and are off the mountain, well, off the high mountain. This is camp two, hive of activity today, well, this evening. Everyone packing up, basically. I think that's pretty much it for the season. There might be a couple more that try and do very, very late summits, but yeah, it's unlikely. So anyway, just to give you a quick view. Amazing, all this work goes into establishing camps over the course of weeks and weeks and weeks, and then it just has to be ripped down very quickly and everyone bails, because clearly there's no other reason to be here unless you're climbing. Anyway, there you have it, a bit of a panorama of camp closing down. Au revoir.
Stunning, aren't they? They never fled.